What's good, YouTube? And welcome to the house. If you got into Yu-Gi-Oh! From Zexal and beyond, you might only know of one mech monster, the Mech Knights, and that engine that continues to go on with the World Legacy lore. Yeah, Girsu's a Mech Knight. But these are the Mech Lords from the Synchro era, and they are interesting in how they've been developing, so I can't wait to read the rest of them and see how it turned out. But before we get into being a reaction channel, let's check out Stay Classy LLC having their new Dark Magician Girl, the Dragon Knight Field Center. And I, to be honest, didn't think this would look as good as the pictures once again. The blue on blue into teal and blue on the Dark Magician Knight. Like, I did not think this would turn out the greatest yet. Here it is, looking freaking amazing as the camera focuses in, and I couldn't be happier. And John, do the noise. These are stainless steel, and they do not damage easily. I'm not scared to do that, and like the name of the company, they are pretty darn classy. That's why the high price point, you pay for the quality, but with code WHATSGOOD5, you can save yourself 5% off on this. That being said, now let's become a reaction channel and see what we've got to work with, starting with the big boy, Mech Lord Astro Dragon Triskelia, a Dark Level 10 machine special summon effect, attack 3000, defense 0. You cannot normal summon or set this card, must first be special summoned from your hand by banishing 3 Mech Lord monsters with different names from your graveyard. So that's a lot of groundwork to have to get up into this guy. Hopefully there's some kind of enabler for that, or you're gonna have to be tutoring them out. Once per turn, when this card declares an attack, you can equip one monster from your opponent's extra deck to this card. It doesn't say random, so I'm guessing you get to look and pick. That's pretty darn big, but it is on an attack declaration, so you gotta get to that point and it's gotta not get negated. This card's attack gains equal to the total of attack of all monsters equipped by this effect. So depending what you pull, you actually rip out Opelousas, you're not adding anything, but you look through, if you do get to choose, you just add 3,000 attack to this man's, and that's on attack declaration, so this will be before you know the attack's done. While this card is equipped with a synchro monster specifically, whoa, synchros are actually pretty big right now between, you know, Crystal Wing and Borload Savage and all sorts of stuff in the meta, it can attack monsters up to 3 times during the battle phase. Yo, steal a savage, get thick, and make a lot of attacks. It is monster locked on those attacks, but we've seen with Juggernaut Leap, that's not necessarily the worst thing. So a battle-based boy overall that takes a pretty chonky summoning condition. We'll see if it gets any help. Mech Lord Nucleus Infinity Core. Dark level 1 machine effect, so easy to get to the graveyard for the big guy. You can just link him off if there's no restrictions. Attack 0, defense 0. You can only use this card's first and third effects once per turn. If this card is normal or special, gotta love that clause, you get both. You can add 1 Mech Lord spell slash trap from your deck to your hand. A tutor, but only for spell and traps. Okay, so don't get too excited maybe. We'll see what they come up with. Cannot be destroyed by battle once per turn. This is an old school effect. I love cards that get the, yeah, I'm gonna live once, but he's 0 attack and defense, and not the greatest thing. If this card is destroyed by a card effect, oh, I'm tougher because of the battle, special summon a Mech Lord Emperor from your hand or deck, ignoring its summoning conditions, with a different attribute from the monster you control. So if it's destroyed, you would have none. Also, for the rest of the turn, only one monster you control can declare attacks. Well, there you go. You can pop it yourself because it does not say opponents. It ignores summoning conditions, so hello. And it also searches the spell or trap. That's looking pretty good. That's looking really freaking good. Wow, what a card. All right, we get into Mech Lord Army Arsenal of Obligato. Level 4 light machine effect monster. You can only use the first and second effects of this card's name once per turn. During your main phase, you can destroy this card, and if you do, special summon 2 Mech Lord Army monsters from your deck and defense position, except Mech Lord Army Arsenal of Obligato. I forget which one specifically are Mech Lord Armies, but he can't be getting himself. But you cannot special summon monsters the rest of this turn, except machine monsters, so maybe some synergy with some other certain decks. Interesting there. If this card is sent to the graveyard, you can activate this effect. During the end phase, inflict 100 damage to your opponent for each Mech Lord monster you control. A little little tiny burn, but I guess it can add up with the big, thick boy. Okay. I see where they're going with that. Let's see this. Mechlord Assembly. Continuous spell. You can only activate a card with this card's name once per turn, and can you only use the second and third effects of this card's name once per turn each. Okay. When this card resolves, you can add a Mechlord monster from your deck to your hand, so you can search the spell with the other guy to search a monster. So he is direct access to monsters, but you can only play once per turn, making that a hard once per turn as well on that effect. You can discard one card, then target a monster you control, destroy that monster. You can literally, search, pop, summon. Wow, what a little setup there that they've made. They just directly handed it to you. If a face-up Mechlord monster you control is destroyed by battle or card effect, so even with this own effect, you can target one other face-up spell and trap on the field, destroy that card. Maybe there will be something you want to destroy of your own, or maybe it's just your opponent's floating. Hey, it's an Altimistic Mine. We have that going for us, right? Like, not bad. All right. And also, you lower your own count against Mystic Mine. Mechlord Control, quick play spell card. You can only activate a card with this card's name once per turn. Target a Mechlord monster you control. That monster's attack becomes equal to the total original attack of all Mechlord monsters on your field, but your opponent takes no battle damage. Ah, that clause, but it's necessary on the cards like this, involving that monster till the end of the turn. I get really big, as if you needed extra help with it. If a Mechlord monster you control would be destroyed by battle or card effect, you can banish this card from your graveyard instead. So a little bit of extra. Yeah, I'm living three battles. Okay, calm down there. We got a trap card here. Cruel Mercy of the Mechlord Astro. A normal trap card, the first and second effect of this card's name can only be used once each. Target three Mechlord monsters in your graveyard with a different name. So again, we're getting all the way to three. Either add those monsters to your hand or special summon them, ignoring their summoning conditions, but you cannot special summon monsters until the end of the next turn, except machine monsters. Man, they are really wanting you to flood the graveyard, and they are really liking to ignoring the summoning conditions of these cards. If you control a Mechlord Astro monster, you can banish this card from your graveyard, and it doesn't say anything about the turn of synth it's looking like, so you can Foolish Burial Goods this. Destroy one synchro monster your opponent controls, and if you do inflict damage to the original deck. Okay, the anti-synchro cards are here. Crystal Wing, you better be watching out. These cards are gonna run wild on you. I do like that they are keeping to the original theme of countering synchro monsters and giving bonuses, but they don't focus necessarily on the fact of your opponent needing synchros or relying on synchros. They just get extra bonuses. This is where I like card design. They pay homage to where these cards come from, but they don't get crippled by it, and that's what you want to see in card design. They set up kind of a not the heftiest summoning condition, even if you didn't manage to get this out, but they have multiple ways to cheese this out with ignoring its summoning condition, and it's an all right boss monster. It's not overly broken, it's not underwhelming, it's at the perfect place that it needs to be in terms of card design to be able to get in there. And then you have an insane enabler for the deck, letting you literally go anywhere you want for the most part, because it's going to be destroyed, and you can special summon that from your hand or deck for the Emperors, and that's pretty cool too. I believe he is an Astro though, so you're going to go for your Emperors, huh? So you're not going to summon the big guy. Ooh, that's part of the live reactions, huh? You're only going for the Mechlord Emperors is what Nucleus is going to offer. And then again, the army going only into the army. They're really actually quadranting this off into the different sections of what you get to play with. Interesting. I do like that they've seemed to think this out a lot more than I would have given them credit for. I thought this was going to be more of an afterthought of this duelist pack alongside the Genzo support, alongside the Merrick support. I thought this wouldn't be pretty much as cool as it is, but they managed to tie it all together. They managed to do it in a decent fashion, and here's some reprints, you know. There's not really a bad feeling left in my mouth. There are bad tastes. When it comes to duels packs, I typically don't expect the best of cards. That's why versus a structure deck, like with the Sacred Beast, I might have had higher expectations. Whenever there's a structure deck, you pool all these cards together, and this one gifted thing is supposed to take the deck to what it feels like is the next level. But when it comes to a duels pack, the expectations are usually low. Like, Legendary Duelist usually only provides a couple of cards, yet a new facelift to these decks to make them playable, to make them rogue. And I think this checks off all the marks for this, for Genzo, for the you know, Merrick support. I like this duels pack as a whole, but at the same time, it's not like it's groundbreaking yet, it feels like. It's not like it really tears into everything. We'll see if there's any more reveals coming for this or how it will tie together in the US, but I'm a fan. I'm a pretty big fan. What do you guys think of everything? How do you like how this turned out and the other support turned out that's going to be in here? Please subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed the conversation, and check out Stay Classy for their new Metal Field Center and some other cool ones that will be coming up. Thanks for watching, everybody.